Welcome to Azeotropia Academy. This is Devdatta and I will be discussing a very important question of GATE, specifically GATE 2020 question. Okay, many students have asked me about this question. So before getting into it, a little bit about me. I'm a BTech final year student at Jadavpur University. I have secured an All India rank of 150 in GATE 2020. I have a research paper which is under review. I have been placed at a top pharmaceutical company from campus and I have 4 months of research experience at IIT Kharagpur. So this is the mass transfer operation question which appeared in GATE 2020, and we will be discussing this in detail, right? So if you have not attended the mass transfer lectures, or you don't have any idea about mass transfer, or you don't know what is chemical engineering thermodynamics, this might not be the right video for you. You have to wait before you cover those that part of the syllabus, and then you come back to this video, right? So these are the prerequisites. So I would suggest you to read the question and try yourself, and then come back to this video. Okay, so I hope you have tried it. So let's get right into it. So basically what it is saying is that you have a feed which is consisting of E and F, two components in a binary mixture, and we have the XY diagram for distillation operation for basically two different pressure operations, right? And we have feed which consists of 80 mole percent E and 20 mole percent F. And our target is to achieve 99.5 mole percent E. That is the target, right? That is the final product. And a sequence of two distillation columns, one operating at P1, another operating at P2. This one is operating at P1, this one operating at P2 will be used for this operation, right? So it's very clearly mentioned. And it's also given that the mole fraction of the intermediate mole fraction over here, E is 0.9. So we have to find out two things basically. First, whether the high purity E is recovered from the top or the bottom, right? And also, is this at a higher pressure than this, or it is vice versa? Which one is it, right? So let us see. So before getting deep into this topic, I will explain you a very typical topic which many students might not have heard about, which is pressure swing distillation. Once you have understood this topic, this will become very clear to you very soon. Okay, let us see how. Suppose, look at this diagram right here. It looks complicated, it is very simple. Let me explain. This is the feed. Okay, this is the feed and this is the first column, right? And you have some top product, some bottom product, D1 and B1. And that D1 has been flashed to a lower pressure and we have F2. We are calling that F2 and we are again sending it to a low pressure column, and D2 and B2 we are getting, right? This is the operation. This is just an operation. Now, what is basically happening and why are we going through this complicated looking process, right? So let us look at the TXY diagram above, right? This is the TXY diagram and I want your complete attention right now. So this is the feed line, okay? This is where your feed is right now. Okay, feed is here, F1. This is your feed and your target is to achieve separation in terms, whatever your end product is, it should be at the extremities, right? That only then will you have completely separated two different components with high purity, right? That is your aim. So whatever your binary mixture is, you want this point to somehow end up here. It can end up at any height along this line. The temperature doesn't matter, but what matters is it should end up, one point should end up on the right side, another point should end up on the left side. This is your first initial point. So basically at this pressure, basically this is at a higher pressure, and what you have is you are separating it into one fraction B1, another fraction up to D1, okay, D1, this point. Now obviously at B1 you are having this one, okay, no problem. So B1 is the bottoms, which is quite pure. It is not very impure. Okay, it's quite pure. But D1, you cannot go to the extreme because you have this point over here, right? This is forming an azeotrope, and you cannot cross this point, as we all know. So I expect you to know at least these basic things about the azeotrope. Okay, you cannot cross this point. Okay. So basically, what is happening is, since you cannot cross this point, what you do is you lower the pressure so that the same azeotrope will have the azeotropic composition at a slightly different point, so that you can bypass this point. Okay, if I lower the pressure to, suppose, F2, which I have, so D1 to F2. So since it gets lowered, now what you can do is you can again separate it into two parts. One is B2, another is D2. Now you can see that we had already achieved B1, one extreme, and we are already achieving again B2, another extreme. Now you might ask, okay, what is happening to D1? D1 is okay. I will talk about D1 also, but it is not of very high concern. But I will still talk about it for the matter of completion, right? So I'll just go through it briefly once more, quickly, okay? Since this is at a higher temperature, right? B1 is at higher temperature, obviously, because it basically, you can temperature y-axis. It is at a higher point, so it is the bottom product, higher temperature, heavier product, so it is coming out of the bottom. The other one is going out of the top because it is cooler and it is more volatile. Okay, lower boiling liquid, volatile liquid. Now you're getting another point, you're flashing it and to F2, since you cannot cross this point, and you have two points. One is the another again one is the higher boiling one, right? That is the heavier liquid, heavier fraction. You are obtaining it B2, right? From here, another one you are obtaining again near the other azeotropic point. See, azeotropic point does not vanish at another pressure, it just moves a little bit. And that little bit is what we are trying to exploit here. Okay. And that we are successfully doing. And we can go further to the right to obtain our products at two extremities. And we are getting the product from the bottom. By the way, this is a minimum boiling azeotrope, as you might have heard. And we have another one for the maximum boiling azeotrope as well, but this one is the minimum boiling azeotrope. Okay. Now, how is this related to the problem of interest? It is completely related. How? Because the problem that we have been given here is a minimum boiling azeotrope. When you convert the let's say the TXY diagram to some simple XY diagram, you will see that you will get such kind of a slope. See, this is the Y is equal to X line, the diagonal, and this line is cutting it like this. So it basically is cutting it like this. And how do we know that if it cuts it like this, it will be a minimum boiling? How can we relate with the previous one? How is it that it is the same previous problem that we have discussed about? Okay, let me show you one thing. So I will show you one thing very quickly. So I have drawn this for you. Okay, this diagram. So I have converted a simple TXY diagram to a YX diagram. Don't focus on this one. Look at this one. So this is the same azeotrope that we are talking about in our system. Okay. I have converted this diagram to an XY diagram. And how we have done that is very simple. You take this point, any the right point on the tie line, you draw it down, take it here, you drop it directly here, you will get this point. In similar fashion only, you can do it for here. You can obtain these points. You can also obtain these points. So any point that is going to cut it like this is a minimum boiling azeotrope. So just by looking at this type of diagram, we can say that it is a minimum boiling azeotrope. And if you look at this problem, it is quite evident what is happening over here, isn't it? Now you have to understand very fundamental thing that I think look at the question first. It is already saying that it is when it is entering this column, it is at 0.9, isn't it? When it is at 0.9, you have to further enrich it to 0.995. That is the requirement, isn't it? How do you do that? Focus on the graph given to you. If you look at this, this 20 kPa line, it is cutting it at around, I think, before or very near to 0.995. So you cannot actually achieve that purity with this 20 kPa distillation column directly, right? So what do you do in that case? So basically, initially, what you do is that you use your 20 kPa, right? Very initially, you use the 20 kPa to take it to around 0.9. Once it is at 0.9, you cannot continue with the 20 kPa operation because it will get cut over here, right? You cannot cross over this point. Then you switch over to 100 kPa because 100 kPa is far away from cutting this line. 100 kPa is already past this line. So this line is cutting at 20 kPa. So initially what you do, initially you use 20 kPa up to this line and you change it, go to 100 kPa and go for it. So 20 kPa, then 100 kPa. So that we understand, but, and we also just saw that it is coming from the bottoms, right? The product is coming out from the bottoms. So they have, so in the same case over here, you can see that high purity E will be recovered from the bottom of the column too. And first is going to be 20 kPa, then it's going to be the 100 kPa. So I hope that was helpful to you. So which one will be our answer over here? So first is 20 kPa, then is 100 kPa. And E is recovered from the bottom of the column too. So D is the answer. So thank you, everybody. Do subscribe and share.